In today's video, we begin the perilous drive out of the West. Why so perilous, you might ask? Well, I'm trying to outrun some really bad weather coming. We will see some fantastic scenery. Among them, Marble Canyon, Page, Arizona, and the striking buttes and mesas of Monument Valley.
We'll encounter some bad weather. And eventually,
Amarillo, Texas, as we make our way towards Oklahoma.
I'm riding in my RV, wherever I want to be, 'cause I'm free in my RV, yeah.
Good morning. On the road again.
Before we go, let's pay a visit to the dump station.
Oh, we have potable water here in the front.
And off we go. Let's check out real quick here by dropping our tag in the mailbox. Speaking of mailboxes, I do have some merchandise to mail, so let's stop by the post office. TravelingRobert.com/stickers if you want to check it out. It is going to be a beautiful ride, as we're going to be driving across some of the most striking landscapes this part of the American West has to offer. Check out those clouds.
Not get upset because I've been there with the old Kia.
Someone seems to be in a little bit more of a hurry than the rest of us. There he goes. That seems much more dangerous than climbing Angel's Landing in the snow.
We are now in Arizona.
Welcome to Arizona.
In my original plan, we were going to visit the north rim of the Grand Canyon. Little did I know, the north rim is closed in the winter time. Still, I'm gonna try to get as close as possible by the town of Jacob Lake. Not sure this is a good idea, but let's go for it.
Well, let me tell you, so far it's been a little bit of a white knuckle drive because, you know, some icy portions of the road here. It's kind of windy now.
This is the junction with State Route 67, the Grand Canyon Highway. Don't despair, we'll be back this summer. I'm really looking forward to doing this again this coming summer, although something tells me it won't be as impressive as in the winter. Although, I'm sure it will be equally bumpy. Let's take a break.
I guess this is supposed to be a road, right? SR67, closed for winter.
There they are, the Vermilion Cliffs.
Well, this is the scenic view.
These are considered the second step in the grand staircase of the Colorado Plateau.
I don't know if it was worth it to take that snowy route, but
No, we did. Let's continue.
Such beautiful mesas here in the West, let me tell you. I am going to miss it, but I miss home more, so we'll continue. So beautiful.
We are almost at the Marble Canyon. Exit, not exit. Pull out, I have no idea. That's where the Navajo Bridge is located, which is the only crossing of the Colorado River on this side of the Grand Canyon.
Well, technically no, but more about that later.
Oh yeah. These are the Vermilion Cliffs. Kinda wish it was a sunny day.
Amazing to see all the different colored layers. Very, very beautiful. It is like a work of art. By the way, I wanted to fly the drone, but can't do that. This is managed by the National Park Service, hence off limits. Here we are. This is the Navajo Bridge, spanning the Colorado River over Marble Canyon. Let's stop right here, so we can walk to the other side. This is something I've actually wanted to do for a long time.
Okay, let's take a quick break here. Maybe we can walk on the old Navajo Bridge, which is, I believe, pedestrian nowadays, and see the Colorado River.
Check it out. Here they have some Native American jewelry.
In this area, particularly at points of interest like this one, they usually have Native American arts and crafts for sale. Some of them really unique, actually. But this doesn't seem to be the case. I mean, they are nice, but I don't see anything yelling, "Buy me, buy me!" You know what I mean?
Not jumping from bridge.
Well, here it is, the Colorado River. And this is like Glen Canyon recreational area. Of course, if we keep going on the Colorado that way, we'll reach the Grand Canyon. If we keep going on the Colorado this way, just a couple of miles away is the Horseshoe Bend, which we might go see next.
To think that not too many miles downstream, this will become the Grand Canyon. So beautiful. There, once again, the Vermilion Cliffs. Here's some info about the old bridge. To the right, the new bridge. To the left, the old. I think they need to replace the signs. Just saying, the old bridge opened up in 1929, and it was in use for vehicular traffic until 1995, when the new, more modern bridge was constructed. The new bridge was built to look similar to the old one, but conforming to the current highway standards. Before this bridge, the only crossing of the Colorado between Utah and Arizona would have been a ferry service, 5 miles upstream.
Well, the interpretative center is closed. But it's really cool, being able to see the Colorado from up here. By the way, pretty chilly, if I may say so myself. It's probably like low 40s, high 30s, but it feels cold for some reason, maybe because there's no sun and it's
Sometimes there's a little breeze in the air.
All right, let's do it. I want to pass by the Horseshoe Bend on my way to Page, Arizona, because I want to retake my profile picture. It's been 5 years and I've changed a little bit. And it would have been cool to take it exactly at the same place I took the original one. By the way, what do you think about this drive, huh? Pretty epic. It is a pretty steep climb to the top of the mesa. The Colorado chugging along like a champ. And we've reached the flat top of the mesa. There it is. I remember that from our 2014 trip like it was yesterday. The Tower Butte, the smokestacks of the Navajo power station. Lake Powell should be down there somewhere too. It seems like the Horseshoe Bend parking lot might be closed. They are directing people to park elsewhere and take a shuttle.
No, the Horseshoe Bend is closed. That's not right. Yeah, they're gonna start charging for it.
By the way, by the time you watch this, it will be reopened and they will be charging an admission fee. Apparently, the site became so popular that they had to upgrade the facilities. Thank you, Instagram. Here we are, Page, Arizona. I think it is going to be a Walmart tonight. But first, I haven't had Taco Bell in ages. And I've been craving a Mexican pizza and a big burrito.
Well, it looks like I'm going to stay here at the Walmart in Page, Arizona, which was kind of the original plan. When I saw that the Horseshoe Bend was closed, well, they have like another parking lot and you have to take a shuttle or something. It was inconvenient. They're rebuilding the parking lot and they put it like booths, like for you to, I guess it is technically part of the National Park Service. Now they're gonna start charging for it. I don't know. I'm gonna stay here. We got bad weather coming, so I was hoping to boondock at the Valley of the Gods, and if we've got bad weather coming, I don't want to, you know, boondock in the BLM land, and the desert turns into mud when it rains. So I'm gonna stay here, catch up, and you know, maybe I'll get to edit a video, and maybe get some propane if they have it, and that's it. I'll see you tomorrow.
I'm gonna get an early start here because the bad weather, it is taking its sweet time to arrive, but it's coming, no doubt. I've been monitoring the Doppler radar and it is relentless. Let's fill up the tank so we don't have to stop. The TPMS alarm has been beeping. Must be the cold temperatures, but I'm gonna stop here to make sure.
Well, good morning, everybody. Waking up here at the crack of dawn, and actually, my TPMS just told me that one of my tires is a little low, so I'm gonna put some air and off we go. Are you gonna say, Robert, you should have visited Page, Arizona, at least some of the attractions of the area? I'm gonna put a link to the video that I took in 2014, and let's explore new things. I mean, I'm gonna pass by Monument Valley, and then Valley of the Gods is the one that I'm really interested in.
Yes, if you are in the Page, Arizona area, Antelope Canyon is not to be missed, and also many things to do in Lake Powell, and of course the aforementioned Horseshoe Bend. Thank you.
as we are crossing the town called Cayenta. The cool-looking butte to the right, that's Aglatha Peak. Monument Valley will be coming soon. And there we're going to take a quick break and assess the situation. Monument Valley, here it is, the epitome of the image we have in our collective consciousness of the Wild West. From the John Ford classic Stagecoach to Back to the Future, to many other Western films. A lot of them were filmed right here. I'm going to stop at what nowadays is known in pop culture as Forrest Gump Point. And I don't see any flight restrictions, so up goes the drone!
We've made it to this iconic spot here, immortalized by the movie Forrest Gump. If you remember, he was running down this road, and at some point around here he said, "I'm tired of running, I'm gonna go home now," and he just turned around and went home, and all the people who were following him were like flabbergasted and all this. Anyway, that's Monument Valley back there. I'm not gonna stop this time again. I have another video where we explored Monument Valley pretty well, so I'm going to continue. And if the weather holds up, which started to sprinkle a little bit earlier, if the weather holds up, we're gonna go to Valley of the Gods, but we'll see. Isn't this an amazing place?
Continue towards Mexican Hat. See the resemblance? It is starting to rain. And there it is, Valley of the Gods, where I wanted to boondock. It is BLM land, and it looks like a mini Monument Valley.
Please, might as well take a picture now, because I have no idea where I'm going to return. It would have been nice, though. Staying there.
That would have been the most amazing boondocking spot, but access is through this dirt road that I wouldn't dare take under these wet conditions. I guess it wasn't meant to be this time. Rain is relentless, and it is snowing at higher elevations, so I'm just gonna make a beeline south towards Gallup, New Mexico, and wait out the storm there. Then we'll continue east towards Amarillo, Texas, on Route 66, Oklahoma, Arkansas, and eventually home in Florida. Let me tell you, even with this bad weather, it is an incredibly scenic drive.
Well, I'm sorry I didn't show you the rest of the drive. It's been a miserable drive in this rain, and you saw it was icy in some areas. We're in Gallup, New Mexico, at the Walmart Supercenter here, and I'm gonna take a break. If it stops raining, I might try to make it to Albuquerque. Otherwise, we're staying here for the night. It's only 2:21 p.m., but... Yeah, it's ugly.